Throughout the history of the NBA, there has been a multitude of great bench players. In some scenarios, the bench player may have gotten more minutes or clutch points and play than his starting counterpart. A good bench player has to be mentally tough. It has to be someone who is ready on the drop of a dime. They can't be daydreaming, have to stay warm, and most importantly, they need to stay laser focused. So, when you think of great backup guards throughout history, some names that come to mind are Jason Terry, a key cog for many teams, including his champion Mavs team, Jamal Crawford, best sixth man in history, Steve Kerr, an important piece to the Bulls' dynasty runs of the 90s, Ron Harper, the same as Steve Kerr, Derrick Rose, from MVP with the Bulls to sixth man extraordinaire for the T-Wolves, Michael Cooper, a sometimes forgotten piece of the Lakers' championship teams from the 80s, Derek Fisher, Fish was a vital role player in Phil Jackson's triangle offense, and was the point on 5 Laker championships, and Lou Williams. Sweet Lou will end his career near Jamal Crawford territory. After looking at this list, all of these guys have one thing in common. That is that they all started and played off the bench at some point in their career, while being main staple pieces for their respective teams doing both. So, when you think of Isiah Thomas, you think of a player from the same mold. Throughout his career, whether off the bench or as a starter, he has been a spark plug. He runs at 100 miles per hour at all times, and he is nothing but a ball of energy and effort. Thomas may not appear to be a starter at the moment, but that is perfectly acceptable. In fact, maybe he can mold his new outlook and journey back into the NBA by taking a look at his former teammate, who I mentioned a minute ago, Derrick Rose. D. Rose only played in a little over a dozen games for the Cavs before also being traded and waived. Most of the NBA believe that the injury bug put the final nails in D. Rose's professional career. However, with a roll of the dice, the Minnesota Timberwolves took a flyer on him, and Rose restored his career and also his reputation as one of the best sixth men in the NBA. If IT were to come in and contribute serviceable minutes off the bench for a team, his journey would look much similar to D. Rose's, which, looking at his situation, would be amazing for IT. Don't call it a comeback, I've been here for years. LL Cool J. Hey, look at Carmelo Anthony. Sometimes all you need is the right fit for a comeback. But what team would IT be a good fit for? What team could use a veteran backup point guard who can help alleviate the pressure of the main point guard and help mold and mentor the young players coming off the bench? Well, there are a handful of teams that for this discussion, and who could still use IT as a nice addition. But before we jump in, please remember that if you've enjoyed the video thus far and can't wait to see what team Isiah Thomas can instantly come in and help off the bench, please remember to hit the like and subscribe buttons and make sure to tell your friends and family about the journey we are about to embark on. Now, let's dive in a bit deeper. IT's most recent stint in the NBA is when he was let go by the Clip Show right around the NBA trade deadline. Unfortunately for him, IT did not get signed by anyone since that time, and also no one is currently interested. Honestly, I think a lot of that had to do with COVID and the season stalling while having the NBA and the teams having to regroup. What can I say? I'm an optimist and will use that excuse. But let's take a walk down memory lane. In a universe that long ago, Isiah Thomas was an all-star and MVP candidate for the Boston Celtics, little IT was the 60th pick in the draft in 2011. In 5 short years, IT rocketed into one of the budding stars of the game, and he was averaging almost 29 points per game, aka NBA superstar level averages. Who did he think he was, Kobe Bryant? The audacity, huh. Anyway, IT always played with the heart of a champion. The man put team above anything else. He always left everything out on the court, as he always seemed to have to play through significant injuries, and let's not forget the tragic death of his sister, too. The sad part about his tenure with Boston, and I remember this vividly because they kept talking about it during the playoffs, is that he was supposed to get a big payday from Boston, but Danny Ainge did him dirty and sent him packing to Cleveland, and he just hasn't been able to recover from that trade. If given a chance, could Thomas still contribute meaningful minutes to an NBA team? Of course. Now, what team would benefit from the experience and tenacity of IT? Well, that is simple, and quite honestly, many NBA players can be a great fit for this team, so maybe this is kind of a generic answer, but it would be the Warriors. Why the Warriors? Easy. IT can take the pressure off of Curry to do it all. Although Curry is one of the league's greatest talents and best shooters in history, he does have a history of injury problems. Also, the team doesn't look like itself without him at the point, so what would suffice? How about a poor man's Curry? IT has good handles, can squeeze through pick and rolls, pass with ease, and also, let's not forget the most important thing, He can shoot threes with the best of them. This type of energy and hard play off the bench is something the Warriors can use. Plus, with his veteran leadership, he can help mold the young guys on the team. Secondly, as I just discussed, IT would be a great insurance policy for the Warriors if Curry did happen to go down. Now, is he Steph level good? No, of course not. But he could run the point for the starting squad without much of a fall from Steph not being there. The Warriors already have a great set of pieces to their team, so if this happened, we would be looking at a starting lineup of IT, Klay, Draymond, and whoever else the Warriors trade their number 2 pick for. Watch our other videos for that. Those three can play with any squad in the league and be the perfect bridge until Curry can come back healthy, or even better. The third reason IT would be a great fit for the Warriors is because he could possibly be used in an extremely small version of a new death lineup with the way they spread out their offense and are unselfish with one another. With his shooting ability and Energizer Bunny style of play, he can easily keep up with anyone in the league. IT, Steph, Klay, Draymond, and Superstar 4? I'd like to see what's behind that door, please. If the Warriors want IT's type of dynamic scoring spark off the bench, why not play that hand out? Isiah Thomas could still have plenty left in the tank at just 31 years old. Do you hear that, Warriors? He's still got a lot left to give. After all of the adversity and pain he has been through, do not count Isiah Thomas out just yet. Hopefully, with his time off because of the pandemic, I'm betting he comes back with fire in his eyes, and it would be great to see.